is there right screen now? Hello?
Yeah, it's not appearing.
Can you see the screen?
No, no.
Well, it is sharing. It is saying that you are showing the screen. Okay, shall we log out? I'll log out and log back in again. Okay.
Okay.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, Anil, is there any problem?
Actually, screen is not appearing from there.
Okay. Okay, I will take care of that. Just now, power is.
Okay.
Make it as a presenter. Okay, yeah, show me. Now are you able to see the screen?
Yeah, it's appearing right now.
Okay.
We're able to see right now.
Okay, now we can see it. Okay. So I'll just delete what I have done and then do it again. Okay. Basically, we are creating a new component. So we have to bring a component folder. Same thing as a page level component, but this is our component that will be used in the page. Okay. Give it some name,
okay.
Title, some description. We don't need any of these things. We don't need any allowed parents. Just say OK, and it will be all red button. So I'm repeating it again. You'll have to do a save one. Okay.
Okay.
Now I can do the whole development here, or I can do it in the Eclipse. I will show how to do it in the Eclipse. Okay.
Okay.
So I'll have to make a package out of this new thing. Okay, so that anything will be thing.
Okay.
So I will give a training demo from package name 1.4. Okay.
Okay.
Then edit, filters, add filter. This one we know it again, but I am repeating it so that you can see it. Okay. And then we will have to give the training new. Okay. So this is done. And then that is simply equal to the save. And then that is simply equal to win. Then we have downloaded the training demo.
Okay.
Okay. Now, where is my project? My project is, first let us find out where my project is.
Okay.
On the directory it is here, training demo my project. Okay. I'm already there. Okay. And then I will have to be, what did I say? It's in the content, all the JSP should be placed. On JSPs means all the components. Okay. So CD, SRC, CD main, finally you go to CD content. Okay. And CD JCR root. This is where all our components are. And we are in the apps. Okay. So I just open dot in Windows, you can simply do open. Okay. And then I will also go to downloads. Okay, I will open this zip file by clicking on it. Okay, and then okay. I will have to, I don't have to copy JCR root or I don't have to copy meta-inf because I will already have my own meta-inf. Okay.
Okay.
So JCR apps we don't need, we need this entire folder. Okay, copy this one here. And then we again will open. Okay, and then we are pasting it in that place where it is there. Okay. Now, there is something called as filter that prevents everything from getting uploaded. Okay. So, that name is filter.xml. In Unix, I just will find. Okay. So, Okay, meta nf vault filter dot xml.
Okay.
Let us see if we can get that from Eclipse, because previously I was trying to let me think. So go to my project hyphen content. I can't access it. Yeah, vault filter dot xml.
Okay.
See, now it is saying that it is only going to allow apps my project, because when we created our project we called it as my project, but we are calling our folder as what are we calling our folder? We are basically calling our folder as training demo.
Yes.
Okay, so training me. Not being demo or something. Okay, so I'll just get the file name. What did I do? I just went there. I simply renamed so that I can copy and paste it directly, but I'm not going to rename it. I'm just going to copy. Okay, this folder I copied it. And from here, I will be able to get this one. Okay, so thus you will be able to get the filter. Okay. So that one is what we have got as the filter.xml. And then you will be able to get that one here.
Okay.
All right.
Right.
Now, so what will happen? Now we can now refresh our project. Now we'll try to code our JSP here.
Okay.
Okay. My project has some content. We refresh the project because we copied something there. All right. So
yes.
See, I have a component for all here now.
Okay.
Top node demo. Okay. So now what needs to happen basically, we need some tag libraries to be imported.
Okay.
Here all this nonsense that is here, because by default it is here. We don't need all of this because our JSP will now be not cleaner. We don't have to put scriptlets in it. We'll use a standard tag library. Let's import our tag library. Okay. So what is the tagline directory? Less than percentage at the rate. Tagline directory is like this. Okay, tagline control space. If you do, then you will do the control space. Control tag prefix equal to. We can give anything, any prefix that we want. Okay.
Okay.
And then URL control space. Okay. Control space. HTTP colon slash yeah, see our taglib is here.
Okay.
So this is what is important. That is why the URI is important. This is standard Java concept. Okay, there is nothing related to it. Okay. Plus we also need one taglib for standard tag library. Okay, so I just copy and paste this. And that will be on the usual convention is you can give any and then I will also want to do an import just in case something might break. Okay, so I will just do a page import of Arabist and this one. So let me just copy a few things from previous one that we have done. Okay, so we will just do some page import, but of course this page import will not be in the gateway. Okay, so form we will give it as Adobe training. What was our package? Control here. Form.training.training.taglibs.mypagetable. Okay.
Okay.
So this is, see, that is the advantage of doing everything. Okay, in Eclipse you can do control space and you can get everything. Okay, that feature is not there in CRXD. It will be like completely what that window is there. We can't do anything. Okay, but
yes.
We now, but we have to do something like developing new component, once we get it, we know how to get it back into our Eclipse. How did we do that? We created a package, we downloaded the package, we unzipped the file and copied it and removed the void filter. Okay. So now means we got that one. All that we need to do is iterate over this one. Okay, first we have to give our this one. Okay. So first we have to invoke our top NAN. Okay. So what is this one? Let us do that. Top NAN colon NAN children. Parent page equal to $. That is simply that we have learnt before. Okay, we are just passing this as an input. Understood. Alright.
But
$ current page. Whatever is the current page, we are just going to pass that as this one. Okay. Now where did we put our this one? Let us take a look at our code. I forgot. Where did we put it? We put it in a array list whose name is referenced by this particular child page. Yes, so let me remember this so that I can refer to the correct one. Alright. So all that we do is this one. So less than C colon for E. Right. Items equal to then var equal to. Okay. So items equal to what? And where var just you can simply do anything var here. Okay. And I just need some HTML pasting to upload that on there. Let me just put the HTML. So guys, have you followed this code?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So what we are doing is this child pages that has come here is because okay. Our navigation tag we are putting this in the page context.
Okay.
And then in the page context we are iterating over it. I am calling each individual thing as child. I am iterating over all the things and putting the list item there. Okay. We need list item. We href whatever is the child dot path, child dot w. But our child dot path, what is our name? What did I give my name? Forget it, right? Okay, so basically, okay, we can just do navigation tag here. We can just use interval XML, we don't need it anymore. Then we do form mode XML. So window shift R in Eclipse, if you do, we can child for what was our photo object called? Alright, so we are calling it as Python. We are calling this Python, but now we are calling this as URL. So we are just going to do that URL. Okay. So ahref means linking to that particular thing with the title. That's all we have done. Okay.
Okay.
Alright. Now,
yes.
What we need to do now, if you look at it, I don't need another extra of this one. Okay. Now, see, my JSP file is very simple on this one.
Okay.
If I look at the JSP file here, okay, so we have done all our development here. If you look at the JSP file, it is like this. Okay, nothing, no code is written there. Okay, so let us put some function. Okay. Training. For top this is just this one. Okay, come on. Okay, now what do? We again run the Maven command to take it up there. Okay.
Okay.
Alright, so where should we be there? At the top level root of the project, we should be there where the POM file is. Okay, so edit, copy. This is cd, edit, and then paste. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Now this is there. So just create type. This is the beauty of Unix. You can always. Okay. So this is looks like the dial remember that one. So we are moving. Okay, so all that is there is this this is automatically generated when we run that one. Okay. So we simply do this. Okay. Escape shift to this. And then we will be able to do this one. Okay. So Maven minus the auto install package in and then install.
Okay.
All right. It has been success. Now let us refresh our this one by using this one. Let us see what is there. See, the tag now is there here. See that?
Yes, sir.
Anil and Malik, yeah.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
It has come to our CPU. Okay, that is why we have to use this procedure. This procedure is not taught by anybody. That's why everybody is using CRHD Lite. But this makes your life faster. We can do all our development faster because we have the support of IDE. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
All right. So basically, now we have done this one. Now what happens? We have to actually refer this component in our template. How do we do? Actually, how to do that? Okay. So here we have something called as top lamp. Okay. Now,
okay.
In the CQ, so far we have used only CQ colon include. Okay.
Yes, yes, yes.
Another variant of CQ colon include. Okay, include path equal to. This path is actually we'll go about in detail when we go about the another component. But for now, just remember, it might not be clear that it is the one that gets created, a node that gets created under a page. Okay, what is it? A node that gets created under a pages JCR colon content. If it has a dialogue, only if it has a dialogue. Okay.
Okay.
The previous CQ include was CQ colon include script equal to, because we are actually trying to get the JSP. But here, yes, we are trying to get the path equal to the top map, and then there is something called as resource type. Okay. So let us just this one. Okay. Top map dot JSP. Okay. Okay, so that one will be the resource type. Okay, so we have to put that there. Okay, so it takes this particular tag library is provided by Adobe inbuilt thing. Okay.
Okay.
We can give any path name. We are calling it as top nav. But what is our component name? Our component name is different. What is our component name? Our component name, I think we are calling it as top nav demo. Okay, so again, I'll do a control so that I don't make a mistake. And then this one. Edit, copy, okay, and edit, paste. Any mistakes here? Training, that is also wrong. We are calling it as training.
Okay.
Okay, copy. All right. As a training view. Okay. So what we are saying is we are using CQ include. We are this one you can give any name, but this is a name that gets created under the page. When we go in the dialog, it becomes obvious what is happening.
Okay.
Then we are training new component top nav demo.
Okay. Okay,
this is the component that we have created, but we have to refer that component from within a template. Template is again is a page level component, but we have to refer it from there. Now let us see what will happen. No, nothing happened because we are in the wrong place. Hold on. Make a break. What is the reason why? copy all this error method. Then you will do file and just a minute. What is the URL that we are using? The tablet compound denominator. The first letter try to debug it by doing, for debugging purposes, for picture size, we will try to use it here. Mostly what is happening? It is because the tag limit itself is having a problem with the system. Okay. So this means the tag lib is imported properly only. So if I do the tag lib properly here, so suppose if I give wrong this one, will it break? Okay, that means we are including the demo correctly. Okay. So the next thing is whether it is in iteration or whether the problem is in. Okay, so now probably it should be here itself. So even that one is coming correctly. Let us put some text to see if it can. Okay, something is getting printed here.
Okay.
That means iteration also is happening correctly. Okay. So if I look at that one. Basically, let us use this one. So that means iteration also, there should be only one page. But no, there should be. Is it only one page? English has three pages. iteration is happening tightly.
Okay.
So basically when it means so this one, this is where I think it is working. Basically, it is failing here. Okay, so first let us see if all the pages are completed here. How do we look at now? It's a now. See, that is the reason why the log will help us. Okay.
Okay.
So this is the new window. I will also show you where the log were here. So wherever I installed that one.
Okay.
Author, CRS to start to be log. Now there is a log file called error.log. Okay. Okay, so tail minus f error dot log, that is where all our log messages can go. Okay, what is the log message that we put? We put it as all child pages. See, it is coming, right?
Yes, yes.
See, all child pages completed is coming. Services.html, products.html. That is correct. We are on the English page. Okay.
Okay. And
English page children is what? So English page children is this one. Okay. But so let us copy that this one. Okay, so log messages are showing correctly. All child pages completed, page detail, services, and the URL is this one, title, and then the URL. Okay. So,
okay.
And also the this one is correct only. Okay, training services. See, the path is also correct. Okay. The path is also correct. Even product.html. So we have the services page, and we have this one. So what is wrong? And also the name of it is okay. So that means even that page is also correct only. So that means page details only. We have imported it correctly. Okay, let's do one thing. Instead of iterating it, can we just print? Yeah, see, it is coming, right? Okay. So, title is there. Yeah, URL is also there.
Okay.
Where is it coming? Where equal to child? I think, what should be the items? See, can you tell me what is the problem? When we refer to variables, we have to do this.
Okay.
Right. Okay.
Yes, yes.
So basically that is it. We have used the expression language, we are doing it.
Okay.
Right. So we will copy here. Alright, so that is it. Yeah, got it. See?
Got it. Okay.
So services, if we go, we will still see the same thing because there is nothing below that one. Okay. Product also the same. But if I go to training site 2.html, then we will see English and Spanish. Okay, that is probably because because we added it to the page below it, the design is not proper. English,
okay.
Spanish. We go to the English, we see services and product. There is nothing below the product. Even so, we are on the products page, we still see the same. Okay. So, okay. Now we have made considerable changes. So, best thing is, what I do when they do is, I repackage it. Because we have made a lot of changes directly going to the editor, right? So, next time when we deploy, everything will be overwritten.
Okay.
So, what we can then do is, here, we can do open, no, go to 3D content, okay, 3D SRC main star, VCR root star. Okay, that's it. Okay. Open dot. Okay. And then delete this one. I delete or something. Okay, it shouldn't be there because we will be getting everything again from this one. File system. So always okay. Because we wanted to quickly debug, we made a change there. Okay.
Okay.
So file move to trash. Now it will be Mac because it's going to the trash. So what do we do again? We rebuild the package again. Okay, so English doing this one. Okay. So then we rebuild the package manager again. So there is already a package there. So no need to see apps training new. It's already there. Okay.
Okay.
So we can simply build again. Okay. And then we can download it. Okay. Then we again show it in the folder. Now this is where it is there. Okay, so all that we need to do is copy the right package, JCR root. We have to just copy this one. Edit, copy, training. Okay.
Okay.
Right. So this is it. And now we have to be in the correct this one. Open dot. Okay. So now we have to again run it so that we just confirm that we haven't broken anything. Okay. We already have a package. So we then go edit copy, go to 3D, we go to edit, and then we use this one. Okay, then we have readme.md. And so this is there. Okay. So that is simply equal to edit paste. Okay, we have this package. Okay, and now we basically try to verify if everything is fine or not.
Okay.
All right. Okay, now.
Okay.
So that is it. So now all our code base is now synchronized with that one. Okay. So this is again very important concept. So let us review it again.
Okay.
First, what we are doing, we are trying to develop a custom tag that will do our work. Okay, what do I want? What are my requirements? My requirements are basically need to be the content. I need to this training site too. Okay. From here, I want to first go to any page I go to a parent which is two levels up. If that if there is no parent which is two levels up, then I want to navigate that current, that page itself will become my navigation tool. And I want to get all the children of the page and build my top navigation. That is my requirement.
Okay.
So, Marty, how did I go about it? Okay, let's see how I went about it. Okay, let's see the story, how we completed that. So basically we have a tag, then we are extending it from a class called tag support. This is standard Java concept, nothing this one.
Okay.
Here, this is one more thing. All the compilation errors you can remove by putting better one. Okay. So this one, so probably this is not required. So if you do Windows Shift O, then it will remove all the things that are not required. Okay, so that it's always better to have even no warnings in your code. Okay, that's always a good practice. So then what we did, we want the current page as our input. Why did we want the current page as our input? Because I need to know where am I. So for example, if you go to the JSP back again, apps training new, basically, yeah, so we go back to the JSP, where is our JSP, that is our template, component. Okay. Okay, top nav demo, this one. I want to pass my current page. You know the dollar current page, yesterday we went. Okay, yesterday we have looked at it. What we have done, we can get the title, name and depth. Okay. So I am going to pass this as a variable into my tag library. Okay.
Okay.
So then we will be able to extend from the tag support, and then we are now coming it. And what will happen, the way the tag library works is first the setter method will be invoked. So as soon as the JSP engine sees this one, what will it do? It will first invoke the setter method.
Okay, sir.
The setter method is here. Okay, and whatever I am passing as the current page, I will be able to get it here and I'll set it. Then it will start invoking the doStart tag. What will it do? It will invoke the doStart tag. The doStart tag, I am first doing a logger. Now let us take a little bit break. Where is the log file in the CRX in your folder? There is a CRX quick start, right? Malikarjun, right? There is a CRX quick start. Underneath it, there will be a logs folder. Okay.
Yes.
And then there is a error.log file. Okay. So all our log statements are written into the error.log file.
Okay.
So info is at this level. Okay. From here, we are now getting this one we'll touch back later, but first we are getting the nav root page, we are getting the absolute parent at the level 2. If the nav root page is null, then the nav root, then the current page becomes a nav root page. Then I want all the children. I am saying list children, and I have to pass this page filter, which is an Adobe provided thing, which is taking string request as its parameter. So that is why here I had to use this dot page context dot get request is standard Java concept. So then you typecast it to slang servlet HTTP request, and thus you will be able to get the request here. Okay. And then while children dot as next, that is simply equal to we are trying to get each page, and then I want to put it in a Pojo because I don't want to pass the entire page of code because it's too many things which I don't need. All I need is the title. So I am created a Pojo. Pojo object, this is like if I do control open declaration, right? So basically if I declare the Pojo object, then it will paste directly in URL. Okay, here I have declared one object. I have declared an array list which will contain all the pages. I have set the title, I have set the URL. I am here using the string escape utility, because if there is any XML characters within our string, it will be properly escaped. And then I have added it. And finally, this is a main node where it is important. This character is all attributes that I have done. Okay. Now, that is afterwards what have I done in the tag library. In the tag library, which is a standard thing, we will be putting the tag library, we put it in the source meta NF sources. So there was two directory called the directory called meta NF, and then here I have the tag library. I have declared my tag list, the URI, I am calling the name of the tag class, which I have called. Okay. So then we have invoked the tag library here by doing this one, and we know that it will be in a iterator called child pages. So we simply iterate over and then create an HTML. Otherwise, we have to use lot of scriptlets in order to achieve this. Okay. So we are done. So any doubts so far, Mallikarjun? Any doubts?
No, no doubts. Sorry.
Yeah, for me also.
Any clarifications, any doubts you have, ask me. Okay, alright. So let us take, I didn't eat from morning, so let us this time take a 10-minute break, and also it is very tough for you. Next, we will try to create a component which has a dialogue in it. Okay, which has a dialogue in it. Okay. Alright?
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Now, so far, we have like for hello. So far, our components that we develop don't have any dialogue.
Yes. Yes.
So what does the dialogue mean? You have already done some page creation, right? So for example, let us take one product page, that is geometric page.
Okay.
The dialogue means that I should be able to see this one.
Yes, yes.
The entire thing is called as dialogue, and this one is called as a widget. Okay, where this is a widget, this is another where it is a path field widget.
Okay.
And then this is there. Okay.
Okay.
Alright.
Yeah, fine.
This is what we want to create with a new component. We want to create a page which has a dialog in it.
Okay.
So let us create a new page, and where it should show up in our this one we here this title component that we are seeing, right?
Okay.
That is where we would like to include this dialog. Okay.
Okay.
So first we need to follow some. First we will create a simple component also.
Okay.
How do I do this? Create component. Let us call it as a title component. Demo title component.
Okay.
So first thing that we need to do is, the way I do the development is just put something there. Okay. Even though it is not a good practice to do scriptlets, because this component is so small, we will directly do it here itself.
Okay.
So first I do. So here I am putting something in the script right here. Okay.
Okay.
Remember yesterday we also learned about the current node and current properties object. Either one is same. Okay. So today we will do percentage equal to. Okay. Basically percentage equal to means out dot println short form. Okay.
Okay.
So there is a properties object. Yesterday we went about it, right?
Yes, sir.
Get. Okay, properties dot get. I will put some default title there. Properties dot get title. I'll tell you why this we are calling it as properties dot get title when we actually do it. Okay. Current page also we went yesterday. Dot get title. Okay. But we used it using the expression language. But we are doing this. So tell me, Maizer, we have no. So tell me, Anil, what is the next step after we create a component? What should happen in order to use the component? What should happen? We have to put it in a template.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
We have to put it in a template.
Template.
So basically, we go into our template. We are doing it directly here because it is a very small thing. Okay. So where is our probably it will be there in the header.
Okay.
No, it is not there in the header. Okay, let us open the content of the JSP. So here we have a title content. Okay.
Okay.
So how do we include that? We simply go and we can copy the something from here. We have to use colon include. Whenever you want to use colon, include what we need to do. So we'll clear this with our text. Then we will call it as title.
Okay.
Anything. You can call it as title underscore node and can see what happens when we use a dialog. Okay. Then the resource type will be changing. What are the resource type, whatever is the name of this one. Okay, the component name.
Okay.
The component name is title. So right now, what does this code do? It has examined the education data. Okay.
Okay.
So all this does here is that saying, get me a title. Okay.
Okay.
The property by the name title does not exist. Display the by default current page dot get title. That is what we are saying.
Display. Okay.
Try to get a property which is having the name as title. Otherwise,
okay.
Current page is title. So let us see what is happening here.
I will.
It is coming.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Because we are on the English. So if I go to services, nothing services has come.
Okay.
Essentially, what we are saying here is, this is property, but because there is no property, it is falling back to the default value. Yesterday we have seen the current page. We have seen that there is a property called current page, and that is why we have to include the global.jsp, and then we are using a get title on that part, and then we are displaying it.
Okay.
Now I want the user to be able to the title. I don't want him to give the default title always. I want the user to do it. For that we have to create dialog. So note down the steps here.
Okay.
Well, I mean, you don't need to note down. I just compare with the steps. So here title you go there and then you do something called as create dialog. Okay.
Okay.
And give it as some title. Okay. And don't change the name here. It should always be called dialogue.
Okay, okay.
Design dialogue. Okay.
Okay.
So as soon as we do, it will be this one. Then, okay, now see, let us see what has happened to the page. Okay. Refresh this page. Okay. See, now the green mark is coming.
Yes.
But there is nothing in here. So we need a widget. Okay. Now we have to create a widget in order to capture something there.
Okay. Yes.
Under the tab one, you have to create a node of eq:widget collection. Okay. So when you go here in the CRXD, we'll create node, and then we create eq:widget collection.
Okay.
We have the type eq:widget collection, and then we will call it as items. And then we save it. Okay. Here underneath this one items, and you should always call it as items without any spelling mistake or any. You can't call it in any other way because that is a CQ convention.
Okay.
Okay. And then we will be able to create node, okay, eq:widget, okay, and then we will call it as title. We can call it any name.
Okay.
Okay. So here, the instructions are here. Then you go to title and of the type eq:widget. Okay. And always hit save button, either you will save or use the SQLite. Now what I want is basically I want this as a text field.
Okay.
It is always such a pain to type. All right. So, Mac is properly not. So, see here we have a title node, and then we have a dialogue. Okay. Here underneath the tab node, what we need is a property. Okay, all of them. See, I told you, right? CQ means everything is a node and property, and node can also have children underneath it.
Yes, yes.
So we will call the property as x type. Okay, and the value is going to be x type. The value is going to be text field. Because we want it as text field, we will call it as text field. Okay. So it should be called as text field without any spelling mistake. Text field. Okay. And then always, whenever you add some do something, do a save. It's a good practice. And then what we want is how this property will be stored. Okay, that is why this is very important. We have to create a property called name. Okay, in the name, okay. This is the property of it called name. And start with dot slash. Don't ask me why. That is how the SQL works. Okay. And why should we call it as title? Because in our code here, in the title.jsp, we are giving it as title. So whatever this name is there, that name will be stored as a property here. Okay.
Okay.
So that is simply equal to add it. Okay. And then same one. And the label which we want it to be displayed. Okay, the label that we want to display, we will call it as a field label. Okay.
Okay.
And then some label that we want to display. And the title. Okay. Now, let us see what it has done for us. So, if I go here, see there is services.
Okay.
Okay. So when I click it here, initially it is called this one, but my demo title, I'll give something here. Okay. And then say okay. See, it has changed. My demo title.
Okay.
Okay. Now let us explore in more depth what has happened. So that page that we created is the services page.
Okay.
So to understand the code better, what exactly we are trying to do, we always try to explore the node and the properties. Finally, some node has to be created, some properties have to be set on the node. So in the services, I refresh this one and I get the JCR colon content node. There is, see, this is what title node. Why was it called title node? Tell me, why was it called title node? Because
containing the components.
No. In our template, where is our template? Okay, where is our template? Okay, in our template component, okay, what did we give that? We gave the path as title node.
Okay.
That is why this path has come here under the JCR colon as a title node. Okay. And then what are the properties on the title node? Let us see what are the properties on the title node.
Yeah.
Okay. This is clear. Okay. So basically we go back to here. Then I'll simply refresh it here. Okay. So this is the training site 2. Okay. And then there is CN, and then there is simply called as the services here, and then there is a JCR colon content here. Okay. So on here, on the title node, the property name was title. Why? Because in the X type we gave the name as dot slash title. It came as title, and the value the user enters is stored here.
Okay.
So our code will simply now go there and say that give me a property called title. On this page, under this node I am executing, so is there a property called title? If there is a property called title, give it to me, otherwise I will fall back to the default.
Okay.
So that is the theory behind this one. Okay.
Okay.
So properties dot get title. And then we have got the current page dot get title. This is a default value. So clear, huh? So far, right?
No,
what we have done, as usual, we have basically created a component. Okay, we simply went to app building, and then we went to the component feature, and then we have actually built something called as create. Okay, and then we created something called as component here. Okay. We entered all the label, title, description and everything there. Then after we actually created the title component, okay, after we created the title component, we added some code in the JSP, okay, which gave some default value. Always put some default value, otherwise that highlighted thing will not be visible. Okay.
Okay.
You say properties.get, if there is no default value, what will happen? Nothing will get displayed.
Yes, sir.
Won't know that there is some component there on the page. Okay. So this is there. Okay. And we have actually added that in the JSP file. And then we created a dialog. When we created a dialog, we create dialog. Okay, first we created the dialog, and then it is something for tab 1. Then we create something called as node. And the node will be of the type 2:2:2 which is collection. Collection, and we call the name as items.
Okay.
And under we create a node and we give the type CQ:widget, and then we enter the text type. Text type is simply nothing but equal to the text field. Name is the name of the property, and it should always be .slash Python. And the field label is the one that actually gets shown here. Okay. So this is the field label. It is because we have given it as different, it has come as text field. If you give it as something else, then it will be this type of control. You will learn more controls as we go back. Okay.
Okay.
Clear? So clear. This is, we have now created one reasonably complex component which doesn't take any input. I'm not going to give you any homework because actually the other candidate I have given homework, but first I want you to just do whatever I have done.
Okay.
Okay. Next class we will be homework. Okay, but now let us cover few more topics. Okay.
Okay.
Only one topic I will leave because that same topic will be repeated again in the next class. Okay. But okay. Then you same as that other person, neither with me. I think Anil, you know him. He was the candidate.
Yeah, at the time he also came.
Yeah. So basically we will be joining him for the next class. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So far we have created this one. Now this breadcrumb, it is a simple thing. Okay, we are not going to do, but there is Adobe provides some out of box component. So far we have been creating component. Okay.
Okay.
So CQ actually provides some inbuilt component. One such component is breadcrumb. And we will also okay. In the foundation, this is just to show that CQ also provides some component. Okay.
Okay.
Lib2 foundation component. Okay. So we want to add a breadcrumb component. Okay, this is simple change. I think everybody will easily be tell me how will we do it. We simply go to Xerox Lite.
Xerox.
Then we go to the template, page template. Okay, so that is basically our page page level components are all here. And then that is simply equal to the new content page in the content.jsp. Okay. Hello?
Yes.
Yeah,
okay. So here we just want a breadcrumb. So again our friend is include here.
Okay.
But here it is not in the training loop. It is in the foundation which is called, which is the foundation component which CQ gives to us.
Okay.
So foundation okay. Components breadcrumb. All right. Foundation okay. Component breadcrumb. See, the breadcrumb has come. Okay.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now we can always go to the edit and edit view. No, I don't want. I want to edit it. Let's see this. Something broke in my browser, I guess. But you should be able to see that green thing, okay? All right.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Now, if I go to any other page in the in this one,
okay,
in the geometrics page, okay,
okay.
So basically, we go to image page. This one, what is it doing? See, it says drag components, and I can drag any components that are here.
Okay.
Start, download, flash, limit, okay, image component or anything. Okay.
Okay.
But I want the same functionality in my page.
Okay,
and it's a very simple change. You don't have to do anything. Except include another foundation component. This is out of box CQ component called Paths.
Okay.
Which is thought form for paragraph system. Okay.
Okay.
So again, we simply go here and then there is called as basically we will have apps training, okay, and then this is simply called as the paragraph system. Okay, so basically we go to the foundation components, apps training, training new, okay, and then in our content.jsp we have a parser. Yeah, par. Okay, so again we simply do a CQ include. See, we have written something wrong here. Breadcrumb, that is why it didn't work properly. See what I mean? If we give the same path, then it will overwrite the one that is there.
Okay.
Okay. So, so we can run edit and then we can do it. Okay. And the breadcrumb also is configurable. Okay. So just a minute. Let me just a minute. So whenever there is a link, then press command and edit. Okay.
Okay.
Control, I mean right. And edit in your case, but I don't know why this is becoming inevitable. Probably because we made that mistake there. Anyway, that's fine. Let's leave it there. But remember, when you do the practice, don't put the same path there. Okay, choose a different path. Okay.
So okay.
We'll just copy this one. And right. Right, and then we will simply do this one, and then this is simply equal to path, we can be any path components, and then this is simply equal to path. Okay. Okay, breadcrumb was actually available in the design mode. Okay.
Okay.
So in the design mode, how will we go to the design view? We simply go here and then press this L-shaped button here.
Okay.
So that's a design level dialog. Okay, we will learn later how to do the design level dialog in the next class. I wanted to complete it today, but I think already we have too much. Okay. So we'll just go here. This is wrong. What is wrong here? It should be foundation. Okay. The foundation components passes. Okay. So we just go here. Okay, so first and foremost, let us see what is the behavior which comes out of this one. See, it says drag. See, now you see this, right? Drag components or assets here.
Yes, yes.
But
yes,
I don't have any components here available. In order to make which components are available, we have to go to the design view by pressing the L-shaped button here.
Okay.
And then it says design of pair, because that is what we have given here. We have given the path here, okay, the path, and then in here we can make which components are available. By if I click it, all the components which the group is general will be available, okay, or okay. We can make individual components available. For example, I want image, I want list,
okay.
I want something like text, and I want a text and image component. Okay.
Okay.
Once we are done, we can just come back to the normal view. The edit view is this one. Preview view, this is the preview mode. Now if I see it, see I have some components here. So basically I want to add some text and image here. Okay. And then see it keeps infinitely expanding it. After I put it there, it has come down here. So you can add another component here.
Okay.
Once you add another component, it keeps on expanding. See, now it has added. So let us add some image here. So I'm just dropping this here.
Okay.
Okay. All right. And then we can add. Delete it. Okay. Just need to charge up my battery here. Okay, yes, so basically we go here, we add some text. And there is some website. So this is it. Now I want to drag another component, which is simply nothing but text and image component. Okay. So you can do as many things. That is basically the paragraph system, and we will develop components. Okay. Our components okay. Also, how we make it available, it is a topic for the next class. Okay. So here I can actually go and then double click on it. Okay, and then I can drop an image. And in the advanced image, this is out of box image component. Okay, so no need to worry. Let's go on this. This is equal to that one. And then we add some text here. Okay. And when you want to preview the page, you simply preview this page. Alright?
Okay. Yeah.
So we have used some components, and as a component developer, our responsibility to make and develop as many components as per the requirements. Okay, but now we have used some out-of-box components. So far we have learnt how to include components by, these are configurable components, and the other components have been hard-coded into the template. In that case, we have to use CQ include path equal to this one. Alright?
Okay.
So this completes our tutorial for today. Okay. So there is, I know that there is a lot of work for you to do. Okay.
Okay.
So for now, whatever I have done, you come to that stage. Okay. Next class, we'll talk more about components. It's all components, dialogues. Okay. Then it will be a workflow session afterward. Okay.
Okay.
So, lot of time, it will take at least 1 week of daily 2 to 3 hours of practice to come to this stage. Okay. So, please put some time and effort in learning it. I'll share you some material as well as I'll share you some package. Okay. Just like I gave you today's package, I'll give you a package. But don't just copy the package, only use it as a reference. Okay.
Okay.
Put it in a separate instance. You can create another instance by going to another folder and then you know what I mean, right? You can go to another folder, copy the jar file, and you know, copy the license file, start a new CQ instance on some other port or same port, but then you can refer to my solution and then shut it down and then come back and then do the work on your own in your own instance. Alright, got the point?
Okay.
Okay. Alright. Okay, then any doubts and questions I am ready to take for today's material. Okay. Malikarjun, Anil?
Okay, that's clear. How to import the, our own images?
How to import?
Our own images.
Own images, that's a good question. Yes. So basically, if I go to here.
Okay.
Image, right?
Yes.
Then you can simply say clear this one, drop an image or click to upload. So click.
Okay.
And then you can upload the image from here. Okay.
Okay, fine.
Or if there is an image already here, then just put it here and say it. Alright?
Okay, got it.
Okay. Any other question? That's a good question. Any other question?
Arvind, tell me that how to upload the building file that
upload the file in the sense given.
Yeah, that zip file.
Oh, zip file. So when I send you a file. When I told you this yesterday also, when I send you a file, you can do an upload package here.
Okay.
Because then it will overwrite. Okay. So here you do an upload package, click, and then when you click on button here, wherever you download, wherever that zip file is there, for example, this one, it is here.
Okay.
You can open it here, and then you can. I am not going to click it this one because overwrite the existing thing. Okay, and then say okay. Okay, after you click okay, it will come here. Then click on the instance button.
Okay.
Okay. That's right. And the Maven command anyway you know, right? Basically Maven command is pushing everything here. So that is already in the Maven minus the auto install package in this one. Okay. So here, if I go there is a readme file that will be created when you create this Maven. The command is here. Okay. So I know it is a lot of confusing, but basically there is no confusion. All the Java code, JSP code, we can do it on our file system using Eclipse editor tool. For that, we have to use Maven plugin. Okay, once we create the Maven project, we get this directory structure for this particular project directory structure. Okay, so once we get the directory structure, we have added all the dependencies that we required. How did we add all our dependencies? We just went to the form.xml file here. Okay, and any library, this is just a standard Maven concept. Okay. Sorry, not anything related to CQ. Any dependencies, anything we have to add it within the dependency. Okay? And in the source main content, okay, the source main JCR content root, whatever was there in the demo, this one, okay, okay. We copied it there, remember, okay, in the zip file, we opened it, and then we copied it here, and then we went to the JCR root, and then we went to the apps training view, and then copied the folder there, but okay. There was also something else, we had to configure our filter.xml, okay.
Okay.
So if we know that there will be something called as filter.xml, where is the filter.xml? In the Vault plugin, there is something called as filter.xml, and here you simply put the filter root as apps training you. So that will take away all our content that is there in here, in the source main content JCR root. Okay, that will be there, and whatever is there, it is now here. So then we can edit all the JSPs using Eclipse, save it. And then again, we run the bundle here, okay? Or you can also use it in the CRX Lite also. We created some directly using the CRX Lite. Clear?
Okay.
That is used this editor. Also, we can use this to create some JSP file. And that's it. So that is, you can do this. But see, the ugly code will become here. They are adding in between the HTML code. They are putting some Java code. It is very confusing. Okay, so we keep our solution very clean and readable, and also very easy to develop. We follow the best practice of putting everything in a tag library.
Okay. Okay.
And that will be there in the main project, main Java class, and then in the taglibs folder, there will be this one. All right.
I mean that Eclipse also is including that three project file, that also my project and my project will.
When we do this command, right? Yesterday I told you, right?
Okay, so yeah, yes.
Then it will automatically create one parent project and two child projects, which are children of that parent.
Okay.
In the bundle, we put the Java code, in the content, we put the JSPs and other things, and configure filter.xml so that when we make modification, it will take it directly to the CRX.
Okay.
From there, in the CRX, we did some edits, but that's not a good practice. But it is a very simple JSP. For example, the title node just had only one thing. Okay, so basically, what was there in the title node? In the title node, in the title node, we have only one thing. So in this one, apps trading new, and then that is simply equal to the component, and then that is simply equal to the title node, and then we have the title.jsp file. Here we see okay. Get title that will be simply equal to the this one. Okay, that is simply equal to this one. So if there is no default value, then we will get this from the current page. Okay.
Okay.
And then we create the dialog by using the usual steps. I won't go through it again. And you can always look at the video and get your point. Okay. So any more doubts?
Okay. Okay.
No. Fine.
That's clear.
That is fine. Right? Okay. Then let us see. We'll meet again on Saturday and Sunday next week.
Okay.
At what time? 4 hour class again, and then we will try to get a bit into the advanced class. Okay. So by next week, you will half the syllabus will be complete, and then you can pay the rest of the amount, and then we will do the advanced class afterwards. Okay. But next week we will do more component development. Okay. I won't give you homework this week. Your homework this week is just to complete whatever you have seen in the video. Do it on your own.
Okay. Fine.
Okay, for the other person, for the other person, apart from it, I also gave him some more homework. Three programming assignments I have given.
Okay.
But I'll be giving it next week because if I give it this week, then it will be complete overburdening you. Okay. So just complete whatever I have done so far.
Okay.
Then? Okay. Right. But next week there will be more programming assignments for you. Okay then.
Okay. Fine.
All right. See you next week at same time. Okay.
Okay.